for the sake of all the people you've killed, I'm going to beat you!
Hey everyone, Warrior93 here, and I just want to start yet another Dragon Ball Z discussion, except this time on a very controversial topic that has been going around for basically years. What is canon in the Dragon Ball Z universe, and what isn't canon? The reason I bring this up is because I just saw Black and Fist's video about what is actually canon in it. And he does bring a pretty interesting film. Isn't going to be a direct response to him, but these are my thoughts of what is officially canon, and I will bring up stuff that he has said and that I will agree with or disagree with. So many of you say that only the manga is canon, and many other people say the anime is built off of the manga or the manga, making things in the anime canon. But the actual answer is there isn't really concrete things telling us things are canon and what isn't canon. Although Black and Fist did say that we all agree that the manga is 100% canon, like there's no ifs, ands, or buts about it, but there are things in the manga that directly contradict itself and what interviews Akira Toriyama has said saying what is officially canon. I will try not to be biased to the anime by saying there are many things in the anime that contradict itself due to filler and script writing, but there really isn't anything that we can say is canon. But in my honest opinion, any event that happens in the manga, we can say for sure is canon. This might sound like it's contradicting myself, but let me explain. We know for sure that the anime does follow the storyline of the manga, but a lot of the time it will not follow the same dialogue as the manga. For example, in the Majin Buu saga, Elder Kai awakes Gohan's hidden power, but in the anime and the manga contradict each other in what Elder Kai says. In the manga, at some point, Elder Kai mentions that if Gohan were to even go Super Saiyan, he could destroy the Earth, or at least destroy the Earth, or whatever. Yeah, destroy it. I can't remember the exact wording. Pretty much saying he could be more powerful if he wanted to. While in the anime, it's a completely different story. Elder Kai mentions to Gohan that his full power is in his base form. There isn't a need to go Super Saiyan. So one thing Black and Fist said, that there are two different canons, basically two different storylines. It's confusing to think about, but they are not two different universes going on. But here's the way I explain it. They both have stories adding on to their universe, making them contradict and yet be canon to the story. Yes, still very confusing to think about. The best example, I think, is Bardock. We know for sure Bardock, the character, is canon. He was shown in the anime and the manga, but in stories he has been put in, there are two alternative realities, which does make questions. Bardock, the father of Goku, and the Dragon Ball Minus chapter, which one is the true official canon? Well, that's really hard to determine, because Dragon Ball Minus is written by Toriyama in the manga chapter, and is a manga chapter, while Bardock the Father of Goku is an OVA in canon to the anime, because the anime does directly reference the OVA with the flashbacks. So DB Minus is a manga canon, while Bardock OVA is anime canon, although DB Minus does directly contradict what Raditz was saying about how Goku was sent to Earth to destroy it, while in that chapter he was sent away to be saved. But that's for another video. Another thing is the history of Trunks OVA. That directly contradicts the manga, as the manga shows Trunks being a Super Saiyan while training with Gohan, and Gohan was stronger than he was in the manga. The history of Trunks OVA, I will say, is anime canon and not manga canon. The last special is Yo, Son Goku and Friends Return. Special only shown in Japan, which we meet Vegeta's brother Tarble. Black and Fist did mention this, but he did not have all the information about it. He mentioned this was only referenced in the anime, but he did not see that not too much after that. After the anime was shown, Akira Toriyama didn't make a manga showing Tarble, but more looking more like Vegeta. Like more resemblance of Vegeta. That's the best way to put it. I read wrong in the script. Looking more like Vegeta. If I can find a picture, I'll probably show it up right about now. Although I may have never read this, but I did watch the anime. And the plot synopsis of what the manga says. they follow the exact same formula. Tarble comes to Earth, then Abel Cabo, whatever the names, just. But again, there are things in the anime that do not show in the manga's version that differ from the anime, questioning whether this is concrete canon or not. The character Gregory does make a cameo, and he is filler that he has only appeared in the anime. So again, the OVA goes into the anime canon, and the manga version goes to the manga canon. But the events are all still canon. This one's going to be pretty short, but the movies are not canon at all to the manga nor the anime, as most of them contradict the storyline to both of them and cannot fit in, although Toriyama did have some input on putting concept and character design for most, if not all of them. They are just not canon. They are not counting Battle of Gods. This is not counting Battle of Gods, although the only thing you could say is canon about the movies is the character of Gogeta, the fusion of Goku and Vegeta using the fusion technique, as he was designed by Akira Toriyama using canon characters. While on the topic of movies, let's talk about Battle of Gods. Although widely accepted of fans that this is officially canon, but which canon is the storyline? Like, is it canon to the manga, or is it canon to the anime? But here are my thoughts. There's a scene in which Gohan does go into his mystic form to fight Beerus, but then later on, while giving his energy to Goku, he does make him a Super Saiyan God. He is a Super Saiyan at this time, but as I said earlier in the manga, Elder Kai did say that if Gohan were to transform to a Super Saiyan, the Earth could be destroyed. Even though he's weaker by this movie, he should have at least been able to put some major damage on the battlefield just by his presence alone. So this does go along with the anime, in which Gohan's full Super Saiyan power is put into his base form, letting him not use as much energy as once. So I gotta say, Battle of Gods is more canon to the anime than it is to the manga. The last thing is filler. The people biased to the manga all say all filler isn't canon since it wasn't written by Toriyama. Well, while there are things that filler that come from Toriyama that they have not realized, the biggest one is the Otherworld Saga. There was a character by the name of Olibu, and he was kind of a tall, muscular guy, blonde hair, and he was talking about how the whole universe of Dragon Ball works. This concept came from Toriyama himself. This is how he could have pictured all of Dragon Ball universe. So, would this be all around canon, anime canon, or manga canon? This is pretty much in a gray area, and I think this would fall under opinion. For me, I'd probably say all around canon, just because Toriyama did picture this as his universe, and this universe is in the manga, but isn't really mentioned. The other question is, what about the other filler? I'm pretty sure I've explained this in a video, but I'm pretty sure any other filler does not contradict itself completely as canon, but probably falls under opinion. By the way, I'm talking about anime canon, as it is extra storytelling to the anime and sometimes referenced inside the anime itself. For my reasoning is there are filler in the Saiyan Saga that haven't directly contradicted storyline, like Vegeta and Nappa stopping by that other planet, and Gohan and Piccolo training, even Goku traveling through Snake Way. Then going on to a later storyline, like in the Majin Buu Saga, of Mr. Satan and Buu's relationship and how they were getting close, and Goku helping out Gohan against his fight against Super Buu with Gotenks Absorb. Although, there is filler that is contradicting itself, like in the Garlic Jr. Saga, which completely contradicts the storyline by including the Garlic Jr. movie, which is canon, and the movie may be a prequel to Dragon Ball Z. The movie itself does contradict many things in the anime, like Krillin meeting Gohan for the first time, and the anime saying it had 5 years apiece, which that does contradict the movie as it is a prequel. So in the end, I do think there really isn't something that is completely canon that you can refer to when talking about what is canon, and as they are respectively both canon and in their own ways. Although the anime may have more plot holes than the manga does, and boy does it. It's still canon to its own right, and everything else relies on it. So I'll end the video right here. Make sure you hit this up with a like if you enjoyed, and for more discussions on Dragon Ball and its universe, make sure you subscribe, and make sure you tell me your thoughts in the comments below.